Hello everyone and welcome again. This is our first module and the second part of first module. So in this module, we are going to focus on the motivation of seismic data processing with real example. So in this module, I'm going to show some of the real example, which is the data set it is acquired in the field. And I will show you some example how we can attenuate these noises, as well as some of the things which we need to consider, either it is a signal or noise. So actually our main objective of seismic data processing is to enhance signal and suppress the noise. So in this module, I'm going to show some of the example. So with that, we will be having the course learning outcome of this module or the micro learning outcome. So its first objective is to discuss and demonstrate the real processing steps and their necessities. So obviously there are many steps which will be included in this course, but you have to see either this step is necessary or no. And the second objective of this micro module is to get the motivation and example of the seismic data processing in oil and gas industry. So if we are looking into the history of the seismic data recording, so initially the seismic instrument recorded data on a moving paper. So in this picture, you can see there is a pendulum which is hanging with this rope. And when there is a, normally it is used for the earthquake. So when this ground will move, I mean, either there is an earthquake or something, or there is a artificially produce the seismic signal or the seismic waves, then this, when the ground move, then this pendulum will move and it will record. And there is a knob over here, is a pen or pencil, and this paper is actually moving. So this one will moving, then once the ground start to move, then your pendulum will be moving and the data will be recorded here. But right now, if we look into the new generation, so that is everything is comes and we have this geophone. So in this case, in the land, we have this geophone. So we, this actually this part will be buried into the earth. So we can push and press into the earth, and this part is actually the equipment which record the seismic signal. So in the history, we was using the analog, then we can convert from analog to digital. But right now we have the geophone, which is already recording each and everything in digital form. So then we can convert into the analog, or either we can use the digital signal for seismic data processing and interpretation. So if you are looking at the theory, so what actually is happening in the seismic data set. So on the left side, you can see this is a person having the hammer, and once he hit the hammer to the ground, so the waves propagate in the subsurface, and there is one reflector, and it will reflect from here, and this person is going to hear this voice or this sound. And the person on the right side on the top, he is actually recording the time. So he will record the time. So when it hit, either hit at this 0 second, then when it recorded at 3.9 second. So actually all the theory of the seismic data is about this picture. So we have the source and we have the receiver, and we have to know the time, travel time, which is coming from this subsurface. Then this time will be converted into with the velocity, and we can know the depth of this subsurface material. But if you are looking into the reality, so here I'm showing you the picture, which is normal. It is actually marine case. So in marine case, obviously you have the source array. So you have multiple sources here, and you have the receiver line over here. Once you propagate or you generate the seismic waves, and it goes through in the subsurface and recorded here. But in between, there's a lot of things happening here. So obviously we have the waves, which is, I mean, traveling within the water column, which is called the reverberation or the interbed multiples also. And sometime this reflect, this waves will come and reflect here. And again, it will reflect from this point, which is called the multiples. And there is obviously some of the fishes in the sea or marine care, so you have to encounter these things. Sometimes you have this scattering object, either this object is quite different, so then you can have this scattering effect because of this object. And sometimes you have this steeply dipping structure. So once the wave hit to the, in this direction, it will record it back here, not here. So that all the things, if you're going into the deep, you have the thin beds, you have the small throws. So these are many difficulties which make your data set very complex. So you have to consider all this thing during the seismic data processing. Then let's move to the seismic acquisition layout, or there are different layout which is used in the industry. We will going to discuss these topics in the seismic acquisition chapter, but right now I'm just showing you an example, or there are some standard layout, which is first one is called single ended, or it's also called end on shooting. So in this case, we have the source in the start on the left side, and we have receivers, multiple receiver on the right side. And if you look at the single ended inline offset, so you have the shot here, then you have the receiver here. Maybe these receivers will be turned on because we are looking into inline only. So another thing, this actually single-ended shooting is actually used in marine case. So you have the shot here, and you have the detector, receivers, or geophone or hydrophone, either whatever you are using for the survey. So the shot will happening here, and once you shot, the wave travel and record it back to your receivers here. Then again, we another geometry, we have the split spread shooting. So in this type of shooting, we have the source in middle and the receivers are on both directions. So if you look at the data set here, so we have the shot here in the middle and we have receivers on the right side as well as the left side. So this geometry is applicable in land case. So, but in marine, obviously we cannot have this type of shooting. And sometimes we are having some fan shooting, which is looking from the top. So you have the source here, your receivers are here on this side. So more commonly, seismic acquisition geometry, you either will have the split spread or end on shooting, which is normal case, and we are following this shooting in this course as well. So if you're looking at the real ideal seismogram, so in ideal seismogram, what you have, the seismic data recorded should give the earth reflective sequence such as given below. So as I mentioned, the reflectivity can be count from soft to hard, then you have the positive, then again positive. And because of this contrast, this is from hard to soft, then you have negative, soft to hard. Then again, you have to soft to hard, small negative, then hard to soft, you have positive. Then you have soft to hard, you have negative, hard to soft. Then again, you have this one. So once you have this type of geometry, so your traces should be looks like this one. So you can pick the reflector. This is first one, this is second, third, and so on. But in actual, your seismic data does not look like when you record. Once you do the processing, after that, it will looks like this one. So this is the ideal seismogram. But if you look at the real seismogram, so in real seismogram, if you have the subsurface reflector, so you have multiple things. So you have this source here. I mean, it's a model schematic diagram of the cartoon diagram. So it's showing the different component of the seismic wave, which is recorded at the surface. So obviously you have the source here and you have receiver on the left and right side. You have the first break, then you have the reflection, air waves, multiples, ground rolls, which is recorded here. So in this module, I'm going to show an example how we can remove this ground rolls. So obviously we will be looking at the multiple air waves and first break picking is the next module. So this is the actual seismogram which is recorded in the field. So if you see, we have the shot, we have multiple receivers, so it looks like this. So in here, you can assume that you can't see anything before you do the processing and imaging. So once you do all the processing steps, then only you can look at the subsurface feature. So over here, you know, you can look at the layers. You have the fault. You have some these anticlinal structures over here, and this is also very complicated structure. Then you have probably the basement over here. So this is the input raw seismic gather, and this is the output migrated data set. So you see in between this, from raw data to migrated data, you have all the way to do the seismic processing. So as I mentioned, I will show you one example, which is the ground roll. And actually the ground roll is one of the main type of noise which is recorded in this subsurface seismic data recording, which is normally in case of ground. So it's a type of coherent noise and inland seismic survey, and it's characterized by the low frequency and high amplitude, also low velocity as well. So over here you can see you have this reflections, but in the middle you can't see anything. So this is the first record, and this is again the second record. So once you move to the right side, obviously your ground roll will be increasing how much you have the number of source and receiver. So how to remove this part? I mean, we know that this is the ground roll. So for that we have many processing steps. So here I'm using the FK spectrum and using FK filter. So first we have the data set in the time domain, which was looking like previous data. So once we have the time domain data, you can identify this is a ground roll. So we convert from time domain, which is the y-axis you have time, and this one is your offset. So you use the Fourier transform to convert your data set from time domain to frequency domain. So now here you can look the different frequencies. So you have frequency and wave number over here. So then you can see your high amplitude looks differently. And this is the one. So from here you can remove this part of the noises, and the output looks like this one. So this one, now you can see the reflection clearly, and the ground roll has been attenuated. So this is just to see before and after. So this is the before one and this is after one. So you can see this is quite good improving in the seismic processing, the ground roll attenuation. So this is before, after. So this processing is not very, and obviously the target of the processing is to do the seismic interpretation. Once we are doing the processing task, we have to do parallel the seismic interpretation. So to look at either we are doing the right processing or not the correct processing. But before that, you must have to plan the seismic acquisition, and which is comes from the pre-planning. So like here, we have to go all the way, go back and forth. So you have to do the pre-planning, then you do the acquiring of the seismic data, then you do the processing and comes to the final interpretation. So if we look at the seismic life cycle, so how does it has been done in the industry? So we have the acquisition initial stage. This is the first steps. Then the second is the processing, which we are going to do in this course. And the last but not least is your interpretation. So once you have done the processing, I mean, obviously it is done in the computing system. So then you have the interpreted image. So you will highlight all the reflectors, and then you will interpret the fault, fractures, the hydrocarbon. So in the structural interpretation or hydrocarbon prediction, you can find out the anticlinal structure, which must contain the hydrocarbon. So then you can decide either you have to drill here or not. So these are the actual life cycle of the seismic data processing. So the another thing is very important, which is the frequency and resolution, which we are going to discuss in the next lecture. So I think that's all for this micro module. So hopefully the next module, in which we are going to discuss about the main processing steps and also the pre-processing step. So thank you so much and have a good day. Thank you.